First, thank you guys so much for joining us.
Thank you,
Aaron, and students as well as online. Thank you guys for being here and answering these very painless questions. So let's give them a round of applause. Okay, and joining us we have Peter. Peter is a representative of PVA, and he's also Jimmy's father. So let's welcome Peter.
Thank you.非常高兴今天来到NCPA，也非常高兴呢，欢迎我们的校友来到学校，大家热烈鼓掌一下吧。今天呢，由我代表 PVA 呢来协助Amanda与一些校友回归日的一些工作，到时候有个互动环节，我们。 会提一些问题，向在座的校友来解答。
When we ask those questions, alumni feel free, Chinese or English, whatever you prefer. We will do our best to translate into the other one. All right, let's get started. So we've got three big topics. One are some general questions. Second one is academic related questions, and then some personal social ones about college life. So first, how have you guys adjusted to college life in a Western country? Anyone like to start?
那我先讲一下这个问题，照顾一下各位家长。这个问题就是说，我们怎么过渡到美国那边的生活？这个跟麦基没有什么。 好，那我先讲我的吧。其实我个人感觉过渡的不太多，因为在学校就学习方面的话，我上个模式跟 NCPA 特别像，因为我学校本身比较小，那班级人数跟 NCPA 这边也差不多。那这样的话呢，在学习上要更加主动之外，也没有太大需要过渡的地方，更多的是日常生活方面的，就是一些。 什么？你出门买东西啊，各种，就是你从一开始非常拙劣的这种，我 I want this 之外，你到慢慢会学会更多的这个一些物品名称，还有他们一些收付款的一些习惯，比如说给 tips， 比如说你如何想办法给自己省点钱之类的。然后其实这也还好，因为在那边有学长学姐。 也会带你，有一些学校它有一些叫国际生过渡的一些活动，那这些活动也会帮助你更快的了解到当地的一些习惯，然后各种。
So I'm gonna move over here, but can hold on to that microphone so you can
补偿 a little bit of my translation. Okay. Firstly, introduce yourself first. 首先最好呢让。 校友们先自我介绍一下，给大家知道自己现在 which college you are studying now
谢谢。那我是余颖聪，英文名 Ken，我现在在弗特汉姆大学 Fordham University 在 New York， 然后在大一嘛，然后我曾经就是。
Thank you.
Yeah. So I'll try to do my best in English, but Ken, tell me if I'm missing anything. So it sounds like Ken feels like the transition actually hasn't been too difficult. He feels like coming from NCPA and going over to his university, Fordham University, has been a pretty smooth transition, except for really specific cultural things like tipping. And other kind of maybe community-wide cultural aspects. And Ken also mentioned that his school provides some programs to help international students to be better adjusted to American life.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Okay, and thank you so much, Peter. So anytime someone answers a question, please just introduce yourself and then say your school. Anyone else? How's your adjustment been? Maybe someone from a different part of the States or of the world?
我名字叫Aris， 我现在在Occidental College， 在洛杉矶上学，上大一。 然后，至于这个过渡的话，我觉得跟高中很不一样，因为我的学校是一个文理学院，也是一个很小的学校，然后也是小班教学，所以就课堂氛围的话是跟SCPS差不多的。 但是大学很不一样的一点，我相信所有大学都是一样的，就是你的自由是将会多很多，没有人叫你去干什么，没有人说哦，你现在一定要去上课，或者说你一定要上什么课，然后有老师监督着你啊，怎么样，就很多东西都是比较自由的，就要求自己的自律性一定要特别高，然后你一定要计划好你这一整天要干什么，不然的话你上完课你真的可以，就是你想干什么都可以，但是如果你要想就是。
学到一点东西的话，你必须要计划好你的一整天。Do
you want to do that in English also? Yes. So my name is Aries, and I'm studying at Occidental College in LA. And I think because my school is a liberal arts school, so it's pretty small, and then the class size is pretty much the same as NCPA's. And I think one of the big differences between NCPA or high school. And college is that you have a lot of free time, a lot more free time in college compared to your at high school. So no one asks you to like go to classes or like take certain classes. Like no one asks you to do homework. It's all on your own. And so you really, really have to plan your day or like plan your week and go to like office hours or writing centers. And then you really have to like be very self-disciplined.
Great.
Thank you.
Let's do another question. What surprised you about college? Or how was college in a Western country different than how you imagined it? Anyone like to start us off?
Hi, my name is Mary. I'm just gonna go with English. And so I'm studying at the University of Wisconsin-Madison, and it's a pretty great school. It's a public school, different from what Aris is studying at. And our school, because it's a public school, so it's pretty big. And they have a lot of white students. We do have Asians too, though, but it's more like a lot of white people in the school. And so, like the biggest difference from what I'm studying at, like NCPA is like, they have bigger class size because lecturers are obviously like they usually have 100 to 200 people in classrooms, and the professor is like talking, like he's talking all along, and you don't get to like make questions, like raise a question, or so it's really different. And the other thing was. Like their sports games are really big. So Wisconsin's kind of known for its football game, and so every time it's the football season, we go to the stadium, and a lot of white people are like wearing red and cheering on the streets, and that's very different from what we learned at NCPA, because we have our games every game, usually in our gym or outside a court. And there's not a lot of students who go to the games, so it's not very as exciting as it would be at universities because there's more students there and it's more diverse. So that's kind of what I think it's different. Thank you.
Peter, do you want to try?
I think just by translate by herself.
Yeah.
Yeah,
no,
originally.
You can simplify it.
Oh. 我这学校是 Wisconsin 大学麦迪逊分校，然后大学里面跟高中跟 NCPA 不同的两个地方，就是觉得那些课程吧，就是课室的容量，就是一节课一般会有很多人跟你一起上课，不像是在 NCPA 一个小课室里面，你可以跟同学们探讨一些问题，它一般都是很大的一个讲那个。 lecture 形式，然后就有一个讲师在下面一直在讲课堂讲内容，然后 就你不会说可以随意的提问插嘴去问老师这个你有什么不懂的，一般是听完之后然后你自己私下去 email 老师。另一个的话就是像大学里面的运动这方面就会比高中更加的有竞争，就是竞争比较强，然后也会有很多不同的运动可以去看，比如说像橄榄球在美国就是很盛行的一个运动，然后在我们学校的话就经常会有那个很大的橄榄球比赛，然后大家就会很多白人还有亚洲人大家一起很开心的去看比赛，但是在学校里在 NCPA 的话呢就是这个氛围没有那么强烈，然后大家看比赛的地方都是固定一个就是在体育馆里面，然后也不是很多学生会主动来看比赛，所以就氛围没有那么就带动性感染力没有那么强，但是NCPA 也挺好。
Okay, this is a question from parents. How prepared did you feel for college? Were there specific class or assignment at the NCPA that was helpful? Anybody volunteers to answer this question?
Should we try someone from the back row first?
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Aaron. I study at Reed College in Portland, Oregon. And I felt academically prepared, but I didn't feel socially prepared because I knew that students in the US are going to be outgoing, but they are more outgoing than I expected. So. No, sometimes I went to a party, I didn't know how to blend into the party. But the more parties you go, the more experience you get. So. Yeah, I think the assignment we did in NCPA were very helpful, especially writing the essay and talking in seminar. Because in my school, liberal school, the class size is small. And so we talk with our classmates, and the essays is in a very similar structure and form as the assignments in NCPA. So I feel more comfortable than other Chinese students who came from a public high school in China.
Yeah. Okay. Do you mind translating that very briefly?
大家好，我是黄昭然，我在波特兰里德学院学习。然后我觉得 NCPA 有让我很好的转折到美国的大学生活，特别是学习方面，我觉得这边的作业形式和那边作业形式很相像，所以我没有太多的就是迷惑吧，就更像比如说写作文之类的。我身边一些中国普通高中去的同学，他们都不太懂那个形式是怎么样，他们也不太懂应该用什么样的证据去支撑。但是在 NCPA 四年来写的那些作文，我觉得就是对写作帮助非常的大。然后在这边，因为课时比较怎么去表达？课时比较小，就是人数比较少，所以。就大家会互相讨论探讨问题，我觉得如果你孩子去一个文理学院的话，我觉得这个也会非常的有帮助，因为你在和美国同学交流的时候，你就会觉得更加舒服更加放松。嗯，但是就是在社交方面的话，我初第一个月我还是觉得很不舒服，因为我们看的电视剧不一样啊，然后平时听的歌不一样啊，生活环境也不一样，所以很多时候你跟他们谈不到一块去，不过你只要坚持和他们交流，你慢慢你就会找到那个感觉。嗯，谢谢。
Aries, do you want to add something?
So I'm still Aries. And I will agree with what Aaron just said. So socially, it's a little bit difficult because, like.You are raised in a different environment than most of the American students. So But I want to say that I see several 12th graders, so I'm going to say that I expect that you still have that research, like AP English research paper by the end of the year. That will be very, very, very helpful. Go to Mrs. Salmonen. Like, this is true because I spent a lot of time writing that paper last year, and that has been very helpful because some American students don't even know how to cite. But I know because I learned that when I was writing that paper. So I'm just gonna give you a heads up, like, that paper is really helpful. Learn how to cite, so it saves you a lot of time in college. 我的名字是辛颖飞 Aries。我刚刚说的呢，就是说，跟黄兆然同学说的一样，在社交方面的话是有一点难，因为我们是在不同的环境下成长的，然后很多我们文化方面的东西也是需要一些时间去适应。但是在那个学术上的话，十二年级的 AP 英语课最后一个作业是写一个像是研究论文这样的东西吧，然后那个时候你会学到很多有关怎么样引用的你会学到怎么去引用文献，然后我觉得那个的话一定要就是给心思去做，因为我去年的时候我就花了很多时间写那个论文，然后我也学会了怎么样去用不同的格式去引用文献，所以我在美国学校的时候，我在大学的时候，很多美国学生都不知道怎么样去引用文献，但是我知道，就因为我花了很多时间写那篇研究论文。
Good news.
Yeah,
大家，所以我们在座的 NCPA 的同学要感到在 NCPA 学习是一种骄傲。你看看我们的学长啊，非常适应美国的大学生活。OK. Anybody else want the question? OK. The following.这是一个关于安全方面的问题，也是有家长提出的。Do you feel safe living abroad, on campus and in the local area? How do you maintain your safety? Okay.
I'm going to do English first. I'm Gary, studying Boston University, freshman. To answer this question, I've witnessed a shooting case, but I'm still feeling safe. What I mean is, you're gonna see different cases happen like every day in the state, or even close to the campus where you're studying in, or like in the city of Boston, we have five or six shooting cases in the fall semester, but you need to keep in mind that there are so many resources that you can reach in by just giving them a phone call. Like, for me, I always save up the BU Police or the Boston Police Department's phone number just in case something happens. And just keep in mind, if you go out at night, go with someone else, go with your friends. Don't go by yourself. And because you have to believe that, no. Like, those stuff would happen, but it's not always going to be on you. So I'm going to translate in Chinese. 我是 Gary, 苏尚豪，在波士顿大学学习。在过去的这四个月里，波士顿及波士顿附近发生过5至6起枪击案。我也曾经看过一起发生，就是在宿舍对外的街道，但是这并不代表你是身处一个非常危险的地方。首先你要有一种信念，就是你是处于一个安全的地方。你越害怕它就越会发生。当然这并不代表你不做任何就是这个安全保护的一些东西，就比如说你要在电话里知道遇到危险你要立刻打给谁可以获得帮助，你要知道怎样联系校警，还有就是晚上出去的时候要结伴而行，就是不要去一些比较就是大家说比较混乱的地方，这样就可以了。因为枪击案它会发生，但它不是经常发生。 而且相对来说就是我觉得在 Boston 这样一个城市，我不知道大家是怎么样的，就是在 Boston 一个城市还是相对来说比较安全的。谢谢。
谢谢。
Anyone else want to comment on this?
Oh, this is Ken again. I'm going to speak English first. So, I live in a city that sounds really dangerous, New York. I bet some of you have heard that the ISIS has claimed that New York will be their target in Christmas, and obviously that's not going to happen. So perhaps say, the United States is a pretty interesting place. People have the right to own a gun, which may make you feel unsafe. Honestly, I feel nervous. I felt nervous when I first went to the United States for the first month, because especially because I live in the Bronx, a place that is well known for its, I'm going to use the word, chaos. It's not that serious, but you got it. But fortunately, because my school has a campus, so it's pretty safe living inside campus, because every school has a pretty complete safety system that can help you. That I can say at least 99% ensuring the safety of your students. The only thing that you need to concern is when you get outside, but I'm going to say it's pretty much similar to living in Guangzhou, because in Guangzhou there is still a risk that you encounter a robbery. There is still a risk that you may lose your wallet when you're walking on the street. And there is still a risk that maybe a pot will fall on your head, right? But it doesn't mean that you're never going outside. There is risk everywhere. You just need to make your attitude transit to living in the United States. You gotta accept that somebody may carry a gun, and that's common. You gotta accept that you may be threatened by something like ISIS, but it's really common and it may not happen to you, like Gary said. I mean, honestly, there's nowhere that can be safer than your home. But that is why you need to go outside to see, because there's a lot of things that's different, and you should never keep the same. 中文简单讲一下，其实就是先讲了一下，纽约是个听起来很危险的地方，因为之前那个 ISIS 组织他不是恐吓说要去炸你，结果也是没事儿，结果现在是暴风雪的炸你，的确纽约或者说整个美国有人有持枪，的确是一个听起来很危险的事情，毕竟这个事情在中国是非常荒谬的。但是怎么说，这其实就是他国的一个文化。那你尤其是其实我们作为学生的话，我们的学校有着义务在保护着我们学生，我们每个学校都有一个非常完善的一个怎么说，叫安保系统对吧，反正就是保护你安全的一个东西。那么你只需要跟着当地的规则走，然后多利用你身边的资源，比如说学校的安保啊，然后就像那个苏昌老同学说的，记住所有的手机号码，比如联系学校的手机号码，联系学校那个安全防患那个手机号码，联系，然后还有当地报警号码等等等，你只要记住那些，然后其他的其实跟国内没有太大的区别，毕竟风险哪里都在，也没什么好说。 你出门，你平时在国内怎么出门，你在那边就怎么出门，还是那样子，不要带我回家就好。
好，谢谢两位同学的解答。啊，刚才两位同学解答，实际上呢，我油然想起了一个著名的定律，叫墨菲定律，是吧？你越担心的事，它可能就越会发生；你越不担心的事，它就越不会发生啊。所以大家呢，虽然有人担心安全这个问题，还是不用担心，因为在哪个地方，可能走路也有风险，吃饭也有风险，是不是？噎着了吧？OK， thank you。
Thank you. Moving on to an academic related question. What is your study schedule like?How much time do you usually spend on homework each day? And do you feel like this is more or less or the same as local students? Let's go with someone in the back. Coco?
Okay, so hi, I'm Coco. I'm currently studying UMass Amherst. And my major is hospitality and tourism management. So basically now I'm studying like mostly Gen Ed course.And one introduction course. So I think the study schedule is basically based on the courses you choose. And some of the courses, they are like way much more difficult. Like for example, if you guys in my like WeChat group, you must know that I choose a very difficult biological science course. It's called food science. And that one is, as aclass is getting harder, you just need to like schedule more time to like how to study it, how to review it, and different course you just use like different methods to deal with it. For example, some of the course they have more like quiz, like those small tests, like those small tests are planned like weekly, so you may have like more opportunity to review the materials. But some of the course, you only have like three exams for each like part of the course. So yeah, it's pretty diverse based on the course you will have. 我在用中文讲一遍。大家好，我是 Coco， 然后我现在在那个麻省大学阿莫斯特分校学习酒店管理专业。那我认为呢，就是你学习哪一门课，就你选的课其实基本上决定了你的学习方式。那这个的话是非常具有多样性的，我具体的一个学习方式我没有办法去给到老师给到同学们和家长们手上。那有一些课程呢它会比较难，你就需要花更多的时间去准备它，或者说复习它，去预习它。那有一些课程呢，它每一周都会有小测试，那这样子你经常接触到这些材料，你也会对它更加熟悉，可能你课下花在它的时间上面就会要更少一些。那有一些课呢，它就基本上就由三个那种大考去决定，所以的话有点像一考定生死这样子的设定，就怎么样去学习的话是非常个人的一个事情。 Yeah, that's basically what I'm saying.
Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Jeff and I'm from University of Connecticut. For me, I think this question is, I think your study schedule depends on what kind of person you are. I think Americans and Chinese are the same because there are lots of crazy nerdy students who have like crazy SAT scores. They will definitely spend like whole day on in library studies.Like without doing any other things. And there's also lady students who probably like playing video games all day long and then getting real poor grade, never go to class. So I think if you are, it depends on which kind of person you are. If you want to get straight A's, you definitely not want to work hard. If you really satisfied with straight B's or B plus, then you can definitely spend some time on sports, video games, social, making friends. So yeah, I think that's my way to judge, like, oh, what kind of study schedule should I have?
大家好，我叫赵景成，我来自康涅狄格大学。我觉得学习的计划只是根据你这个人的性格和要求来决定的。就是说，如果你是一个超级学霸， 你肯定希望你的成绩非常好，你想拿很多的 AA， 这样的话你肯定大部分时间会花在图书馆，花在学习上面。如果你是一个很懒的人，你从来不去上课，你觉得哎 B 加对我来讲已经很好了，拿一个 3.3 GPA 也不错的话，当然你也可以花更多的时间在体育啊，或者打游戏，或者是交朋友上面。所以说我觉得不要给自己太多压力吧，就是说尽量的去追随你想做的事情就好，不用说啊我一定要拿到很好的成绩怎么怎么样，我觉得可以平时可以放松一下或者怎么样。
谢谢。
Thank you,
Jeffrey.
Just because of time, Peter, do you want to go number four?
Okay, 我提问这个问题之前呢 ，Mr. Ho 啊 ，Mr. Benson 呢，要有一个问题，想我们提问一下啊。
我想的是我们这个来这里现场的家长的福利啊，我一定要问一问，我怕时间不够了。我想问一下哈，我们在座的这个学长们，包括在下面就坐的，都能够回答一下这样一个问题，就是你们一定会很想向学弟学妹们推荐你的学校。请你给一个最强有力的理由，一句话，好不好？谢谢你们。
既然对家长就用中文说，我是康涅狄格大学。如果我要推销的话，就针对刚刚那些问题来讲，对吧？康涅狄格，虽然说可能没有听说过。康涅狄格大学或者说它的排名可能不是很高，对不对？但是我们和耶鲁在一个州，所以说我们的学习氛围。这是关于学历方面，关于安全方面，我觉得就是你在做决定的时候，你就会决定你这个地方是安全不安全。城市来讲相对会不安全一些，因为城市比较大，什么事情都可能发生。但是呢，我们大康村就不一样了，在这个安全问题是绝对不用担心。对，我是觉得安全和学习，我觉得是家长最担心这两点，所以说我觉得康涅狄格大学可以保证这两点，就这两点我觉得都可以保证，所以说我觉得我学校非常好。
大家好，我是叶真维，我来自威斯康星大学麦迪逊分校。那我相信很多家长是很希望自己的孩子到了大学也很认真学习的，那我们这个学校大概就是前五十大学里面书呆子最多的学校。如果你们很想让自己的孩子到大学安心学习，没有什么杂念的话，我们学校能提供很好的环境给你的孩子安心学习，但其他方面我就不敢保证。
嗨，对，我在这里就读大学，我刚刚已经说过了，是马什大学阿莫斯特分校。那我们学校最出名的是什么啊？我刚刚终于想起来了，是吃的，是真的。我们学校主厨是广东人，然后我甚至可以在那里就是讲粤语，然后我们有。四个饭堂，然后有两个超好吃。去那边的话，早上你可以吃到那种就是鸡熬的鸡粥，然后还有油条，还有对，
我要转，
我吃到的，然后什么豆沙包之类的东西，就对，真的很幸福。对，除了说饭堂以外，我觉得那边人文气氛也特别好，因为毕竟是在麻省嘛，它其实是整个就是美国大学里面最 liberal 的。就是州，也就是很多好大学都在我们州，就蛮不错的，你们可以去一下吧，吃得好，这一点真的是哎。
大家好，我是 Susan。我在 RIT 就是罗切斯特理工大学读书，然后我是工业设计专业。我觉得我们的大学呢， 虽然可能比不上前几位同学说的，就是某一方面特别突出，但是我觉得我们大学非常的有爱，因为我们学校收了很多残疾人，他们是要不然是有听力的障碍，要不然就是语言方面就是有些障碍，所以呢，我们的课程都会为这些残疾人考虑，然后都会有配备专门的翻译师就是在课堂里，所以即使你是残疾的同学或是不是残疾同学都可以一起上课，然后我觉得这样呢就提供了一个非常有爱的氛围，然后在那里上学的话就是教授和同学之间的相处也非常的愉快所以我觉得我们大学还是蛮不错的，谢谢。
大家好我其实不太推荐我们学校
我不知道推荐不推荐，
我们学校很多方面都挺非主流挺奇怪的，所以如果你们的孩子想真的想去的话，我建议去自己去就是参观一下然后再决定。
大家好，我是 Zero， 然后我现在在雪城大学，然后其实他们刚刚已经把很多好的部分讲了，然后我就在想我到底应该讲什么。我们学校那个附近的这个地理环境还不错哈，雪比较多，这个比较适合南方小朋友如果愿意去看的话。然后我们从11月初今年的第一场雪是11月7号就开始下雪了，然后已经下了差不多近2个月了，然后这次是那个东北部遭受这个暴风雪，我们也算是极灾地区这样。然后其实因为我本人对于吃住这个没有特别高的要求，觉得我们饭团还凑合。那很多人会担心说我们学校前几年一直在这个 party school 的这个排行榜上名列前几名哈，但其实当你真的过去你也不会觉得说有很多 party 了，我觉得这个还是因人而异的。然后也不是因为我本人哈，那个我会觉得说我们学校除了学比较好的话，然后如果大家愿意念这种communication 或者是 design 这些专业，我们学校的 new house 是可以供大家考虑的，我觉得这个是不错的。然后对，主要就是来看雪，然后雪村嘛比较安全，然后我觉得这个会让各位家长会比较放心。对，谢谢。
Ken, before you begin, I'm just going to interject. Teachers who are here, thank you so much for your patience. I totally forgot to translate. So Benson had this great question wanting the students to introduce their school and introduce their favorite things about it, kind of like an elevator pitch. So they're kind of going through the different schools right now.
Okay, 由于时间关系啊，我们就进入下一个主题。刚才呢我们私下在交流，刚才同学呢我看了都推荐，有的推荐自己的学校，但是呢我发现呢他很多同学呢都穿了 ACPA 的一些服装过来，所以说呢 ACPA 还是他们最喜欢的学校啊。下面一个问题呢也是可能在座的学生比较关心的一个问题，关于 AP course 这个问题。Were your AP courses taken at NCPA help for your college?
Hello everyone, my name is Alex, and right now I'm studying Connecticut College.In Connecticut. I think the AP course we study in NCPA help us a lot in our university, because for me, I just exchanged like about 16 credits with my AP course. I study in NCPA, and I know that like in some university, especially the AP calculus PC,if you study well, you can get credit with your AP score, and then you do not need to study Cal 2 again in your university. And I think that's very helpful. Okay, 用中文讲一遍，就是我觉得在 NCPA 学的 AP 课程是对我们帮助很大的。首先第一个就是学分的问题，我在 NCPA 学的四门 AP 课程帮我换到了16分的学分。 就等于让我可以少读半年的书在那边。就是其中一特别就比如说微积分 BC 嘛，因为大学有我知道在我在读文理学院，但我知道有些大学微积分是一个必修的课程，但是如果你 BC 考好了，你可以直接换课，你就不需要再上在大学里面再上一遍 KL2，所以我觉得 AP 这种课程还是挺有用的，而且会让你赢在起跑线上吧，就知识面更广一点。
谢谢。
Thank you.
Some of them are really helpful. For example, the AP English language for seniors, and also like last year, the AP macroeconomics. I think these courses, they can give you some background information about some core courses that you will take at college. And yeah, just like Aaron just mentioned about the essay writing, I think the language class, even though you don't take the test,but you can still get some skills, and so you will be more successful or you will be more comfortable with the skills that you may need to employ in your college. I think that's really important. And that's what Ms. Wilson, the lady in the back, taking for the seniors right now. Yeah, I think that's it.
Okay, we're running a little bit over time, but we wanted to get to two last personal social questions. First one should be pretty easy. What are you involved in outside of your classes?
So, as I study in a big university, so there are hundreds of clubs that's gonna show you, like, it's like picking an ASA.Got hundreds of clubs to play, and you can join as much as you want just to fill up your downtime. For me, I went to an acapella club, but unfortunately I didn't get in because it's too competitive. And I was in a billiard club just for recreation, playing billiards once a week, and also in a music network club to.Seeing different musician and work with this different talented. 就是说因为我是在波士顿大学是一个大 U, 所以说它有上百个不同类型的社团让你去参加，你可以选多少都可以，不选也可以，就是根据个人喜好。我的话我去选了一个唱歌的一个社团是没有选上，然后又参加了一系列的就是关于音乐的社团，就是建立关系网，还有就是参加了一个桌球社团，就是有一点是如果你想就是选一些更有专业性的社团，就是更倾向于你专业的也是可以的。对，这样子，谢谢。
From my seminar, so we are required to like participate a volunteer program for like a couple hours. Yeah, I forgot the like specific number. And we were like working at the local shelters to help those homeless people to like sign up and set up beds during the night because it's pretty cold overnight. So.Yeah, they're providing like materials to those homeless people. So when you're doing this kind of thing, although it's like you are required to do so, but I think you will find your like maybe personal value during those like volunteering work. 那我们中文再讲一次好了，就是我们学校那叫什么？类似于。帮助学生去适应大学的这么一个课程，然后他要求你参与大概几个小时的那种志愿者活动，那我去帮助一个当地的
收容所吧，去装上一些那种临时用的床铺，去把一些他们的个人物品去分发给他们。我觉得虽然说这是一个我要求必须去做的一件事情，但是我觉得在参与这种活动的过程中，你其实也可以找到一些就类似于个人的价值吧，还是对于我来说蛮有意义的一些活动。如果各位同学感兴趣的话，你们也可以去看看你们的学校或者说周边有没有提供这样的志愿者活动给你们，我觉得还是蛮有意义的。
OK， 最后两个问题啊，一个是关于homesickness 这个方面啊。Do you have a homesickness? And how are you keeping touch with your family and NCPA classmates or friends? 吃香槟吗？吃都不想要。
For me, I still have a little bit homesick because this is my first time like being aboard and not going home for a couple months. But you know, technology is very developed now, so we can use WeChat or like.FaceTime with your family, so it doesn't matter. And to keep touch with NCPA friends, like we can, like during break or weekends, we still go out together. Like during Thanksgiving, I went to Chicago with other NCPA friends. 用中文讲一次就是，在出国的时候，如果你有，我还是会有一点想家的，但是。在想就是因为现在科技很发达，我们可以用微信啊或者是视频之类的方式跟自己的家人联系，然后跟 NCPA 的同学的话，就因为大家都在美国嘛，所以你们在大家在周末或者是在假期的时候可以一起出来约个饭啊，或者一起去旅游啊什么之类的。
Thank you, Kelly.
大家好，我叫林奇祥。我先用中文说一遍，就是我觉得 homesick 是就是想家这件事情呢，我在想我自己的家，我觉得家也在想我，所以我父母要求每一周都看视频一个小时，然后我觉得也挺好的，就是每周就可以看一下自己家，因为就是晚上的时候，我大概十点多十一点多晚上的时候，他们正好在吃早饭，所以我就。可以看到一家人一起吃饭，好像我在国内一样，就我觉得感觉非常好。然后关于这个NCPA 同学们的话，就比如说这帮人，我是经常跟他们联系的，就是我们有时候会交流一些学术上的一些东西，然后交流一些比如说感情上的问题，然后有时候也会交一些关于游戏上的一些困扰。然后就是我觉得跟他们一直 keep in touch， 然后我们像我们在 Thanksgiving break 的时候，我们也一起出去玩，就是感觉非常好。English well, when I have homesick, I think our parents also miss us, so my parents want me to have video chat with them every week for an hour. So I think it's a very good way to keep in touch with them.And also with the classmate in NCPA, we always talk about study or game or some relationship kind of friendship. And we also have a trip during Thanksgiving, so I think it's a good way to, I think a very good, a very good thing to keep in touch with your friends and your family.
Last question， 最后一个问题呢是关于和我们在座的同学相关的。If you could start your high school years over, would you do anything differently to prepare for college. Advice for our current students.一个是 AP Language and Composition， 一个是 AP Literature and Composition， 这两门啊，为什么我这么说呢？因为我去到那边之后啊，因为我的 SAT 英语成绩不是很好，然后在那边，然后发挥，因为暑假嘛，一段时间没有英文，发挥也不太好。去到那边考试，就是我们每个人去到那边都要有个语言考试什么，然后我就要上英语课。那个英语课上就上吧，上最低的那个，对吧？但是我们呢，我们学校很，我们就是有 ESL， 然后是 Composition One、Composition Two， 然后 Test and Contest， 然后之类的。然后我要毕业呢，我就必须修，把那个 Composition Two， 还有 Test and Contest 这两门进阶的英语课给修了。然后我要大一升大二，我必须要把 Composition Two 修了。但是现在有个问题，我要修 Composition 2， 我必须要把 Composition 1修了。但是呢，我要先修 ESL 2， 然后 ESL 2， 我们 ESL， 然后 ESL 2， 然后 Composition 1， 这样就很浪费我的时间。说实在的，那如果说我当时能够把这个至少我把 AP Language 跟 Composition 考了，我至少也考了一个三或者四，最好是四吧。那这样的话我就不用了，就算我在那边考得再差，我也不需要修 ESL， 那我省了很多的时间。因为我现在这样子的话，就是把我之前用 AP 换到的分就给互相抵消掉了。我之前修了，我一共能换到21分，其中大部分都是只能换成 elective 的分，那其实很浪费。因为我们选修，我们必修课特别多，那你要选修课其实应该多一点才更加丰富你的校园生活。但是现在选修课全都被我的英语课就多出来的 ESL 2还有 Composition 1这三门不是必修的课给占了，就很浪费时间。I'm gonna say I really regret that I didn't put a lot of efforts on my AP language composition or maybe literature because if I got three or four score of these two AP tests, I don't have to take the ESL course in my university, which is, to me, it's a waste of time, because ESL 2 and Composition 1 are courses that I am not required to take on my degree works, but I am required to take because I don't have proof for my English level. So, this stopped me from graduate earlier, as well as having more chance on choosing other elective courses that can make my college life much more interesting. Because my school has a lot of required courses to take. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you.
先用中文说一遍吧。这如果还有4年在 CPA 的话，我可能会破坏更多的校规，我可能会多吃几次饭堂，我可能会参加多几次校队选拔，跟我 Roscoe 多辩论几句打篮球的理论。但是我并不会特别去后悔我没有做的每一件事，因为过去的一些措施也好，一些成功也好，只会成为我现在的前进的一个动力。因为我们要做的不是往后看，而是往前看。大学给了我们一个更大的平台，而正是 NCPA 这些我们做了的没有做了的多多少少的让我们准备好了去迎接这个平台。所以在心存对 NCPA 心存感激之际，我会说的是你要体验这一切，就算你有措施你也不要感到遗憾，因为你生命就是 来就是为了经历这些事情。So if I have another 4 years in NCPA, I would bring more rules. I would go to the cafeteria more often and argue more with Mr. Walsko about basketball. Or all those kind of stuff, or study harder for an exemplary. Yeah. But what I have to say is, you don't have to be too regretted about what you didn't do back in high school, because NCPA is such a great system that got us prepared for a larger stage, a brighter future for us, and you've got so much more opportunities when you go to college. So take your time, enjoy everything you have right now, and don't feel regretted, look forward, and that's it.
I would say that it will be talking to teachers more. I mean, I already did a lot when I was in high school, but I still think that it's not enough because I experienced a lot of culture shock when I was in college. And I think, I mean, I'm not trying to say that you have to Americanize yourself when it gets to the United States or Canada, but it's good to know what the do's and don'ts. And so I would say, like, ask more questions, like ask your NCPA teachers more questions so that you don't have to experience it. And like know how they talk or what they mean when they say a certain thing, so you don't get confused when you go to the United States or Canada. 虽然我在高中的时候，我也经常有跟NCPA 的老师聊天，但我觉得还是需要更多去了解一些文化上的差异。因为我在大学的时候，有的时候我就很困惑，就我在想他们说这个事情，他们到底是什么意思，或者是他们做出这种表情、这种动作，到底是不是我想的那个样子？所以我觉得在 NCPA 你可以问老师这些问题问得更多一些，这样的话你到大学的时候或者到外国的时候，你就不会很困惑，或者就觉得或者是你就不用很尴尬，就这么讲吧。
Thank you so much, Aries, and let's give a final big round of applause for this class.
非常感谢今天到场的我们首届的毕业生和第二届的毕业生。由于有了你们你们用中国的一个传统的话，你们是 ANCPA 的开荒牛非常感谢非常感谢，真的是伟大的先行者。这个名字用在你们身上是一点都不假，因为 ANCPA 从无到有，也积聚着老师们我们首届第二届还有所有同学的还有家长们的一些心血，真的是不容易，从无到有。所以呢，你们记住Once at NCPA, Always at NCPA。
好，
谢谢。
好。